debut novel is called Les Silences des Bombes, and it's set in July 1940 on the Suffolk coast in England. July was a very hot summer in England, and England was under the threat of invasion. And it's about two main characters. One is an 11-year-old girl called Lydia, and the other is a German soldier. And it starts with the German soldier swimming up onto the shore in the dead of night. And he breaks into a boarded up house and finds Lydia, this 11-year-old girl, hiding there. She's been evacuated to Wales before the novel starts. However, at the beginning of the book, she has run away from Wales and arrives back in her home village and finds that it's deserted. And when she gets to her family home, that's deserted and boarded up too. She hides in the attic, and then during the night she hears sounds downstairs, and when she goes downstairs she finds this German soldier has broken in. And he tells her that he is part of an advance party heralding the German invasion of England, and although he won't hurt her, because he's seen her, he now can't let her go. And that's really the starting point for the story, and it's told from both Lydia's point of view and this German soldier's point of view over the following 5 days while he keeps her captive in this house. And because he won't let her out, she doesn't know to what degree he's telling the truth or not. The story really started from, well, I came across two stories that were true about the southeast coast of England, and in the run-up to the war, and as the war started, it was a very important part of the English coastline, because it was closest to the English Channel, and the threat of invasion was likely to hit there first. And the fear amongst the locals was always that one day the Germans would actually arrive. And I came across two stories. One was about a German, or the decomposed body of a German airman that was washed up onto a beach right next to the location where my novel is actually set. And the other story was about German chocolate wrappers and German clothing that was found on a beach a little bit further along the coast. And the fear, as I said, was always that the Germans would arrive, and that one day someone would be washed up on the shore, but they weren't actually dead, and that then they would be released into the English countryside, and then what would happen next. I think when you're writing historical fiction, there's an awful lot of research that's required for this. And that's a part of the writing process that I really enjoy. I studied history when I was younger, and I loved doing the research. However, I wanted to find elements of the war that I had not come across before, or that I knew very little about. So I didn't write about the Blitz in London. I didn't write about what was happening, say, for example, in Poland or places like that. I mean, where Suffolk is on the English coast, it's a very beautiful landscape, and very flat and dramatic. So there's some writers that influenced me in terms of how I portrayed that on the page. So some of Charles Dickens' work, Great Expectations, is set around the southeast coast. There were authors like Susan Hill that writes amazing ghost stories about sort of lonely houses and what goes on there. So they were a good starting point. And then in terms of sort of war fiction, I think books like Ian McEwan's Atonement is the obvious comparison, because Bryony in that novel is quite similar in some respects to Lydia. They're both forthright young girls. And I suspect that my character Lydia, if it wasn't for the fact that she finds herself in a very traumatic situation, I think before the war she was probably a bit of a handful, and she's very feisty and fun and tomboyish. And I think there's elements of that in Ian McEwan's Bryony and Atonement as well.